I've reached the depleted dig site. Are you in position?
Just arrived. Go ahead and bring it online. I'll manage the power supply from here.
Affirmative. I'll activate the site's generator.
Right. Just make sure you've completed all your other tasks before you get started. This scan could take a while, and I'll need you there.
I'll need to reboot the generator before we can proceed. Power rerouted. Liv, how are your energy readings?
So far, so good. Head to the sensor and bring it online.
Sensor reached.
Look for the main control console. You should be able to activate the sensor from there.
Sensor powering on.
Confirmed. You'll need to rotate the dish so it faces the anomaly before we can get a clear reading. Jack, it's working. The signal's getting stronger. Keep going.
The array is now pointed at the epicenter of the anomaly.
Perfect. Give me a minute to process the data. What the... Jack, what happened? I lost my connection to the sensor.
Energy spike from the anomaly. I think it blew the fuse.
Shit. Those sensors are sealed before deployment. Okay, you'll need to cut through to access the fuse box.
This has to be against protocol.
Well, I find it's easier to get things done if you think of the field manual as guidelines rather than regulations.
The filament popped. We'll need a new one.
There should be plenty of spare fuses around. Look for a replacement.
Power level stabilizing.
Good. Let's get the sensor back online so we can finish the scan.
Sensor's back online.
Connection established. Now we just need to realign the array.
Signal synchronized. Scanning inner horizon.
Liv, array is realigned. Can you confirm? Liv, do you copy?
I think it worked, Jack. I picked up something on the oscilloscope. I'm patching the audio through. Do you hear that? What the hell is this? Ah!
Liv. Olivia.
Jack, I need you. Find a Fury transport and get back here now.
Select your destination.
Captain Rhodes, sit right, please.
The automatic release protocols aren't working. I'm wedged between the trolley and the rail. Can you see a way to get me out?
Negative. It's trapped beneath the cowl.
The access cover. If you cut through the bolts, we can get a look inside.
Proximity alert,
Jack.
The pulse knocked out my cutting tool.
Jack!
Rebooting.
Look! The anomaly is changing. What the hell? Jack, are you seeing? Oh, God. Shit!
Cutting tool back online.
Incoming,
Liv.
Jack! Cut the panel!
Olivia, everything is going to be fine.
That's it! You got it! Shit! Shit!
Liv, Liv, do you copy? Are you all right? Liv, where are you? Nothing.
Mayday, Mayday. Titan Command, if you're out there, this is Captain Olivia Rhodes. Kronos 2 is lost. Say again, my station has been compromised. We were hit by a debris storm caused by the arrival of an unknown vessel in our sector. Damage is catastrophic. Honestly, it's a miracle I'm alive. I'd never have made it if Jack hadn't cut me free. But he won't reboot. He's gone. I can't stay here. Main power's offline, we've lost atmosphere. Radiation levels are climbing fast. I've no choice but to take my chances aboard the unknown vessel. It's a long shot, but if there's any hope I might be able to survive on that ship, I have to try. Titan Command, if you're receiving, hell, if anyone's receiving, come find me.
Proximity alert. Proximity alert. Proximity alert.
Hera.
Good morning, Echo One. It is encouraging to see you have finally recovered.
Hera, what happened? Where is Liv?
Station has suffered extensive structural damage from the debris field. My program was forced into hibernation mode shortly after Captain Rhodes' departure.
Departure? Where did she go?
Captain Rhodes did not specify a destination.
Hera, are there any Fury transports still operational?
Affirmative.
Reroute the nearest transport to the station airlock. I'm going to find Liv. Hera, open the activation bay doors.
Echo One, I am obligated to inform you that leaving the station is a violation of Atlas Protocol.
I don't care. Liv is in trouble. I'm going to help her. Now open the doors. Hera, can you locate Liv's transport?
Negative. Sensor network offline.
What if I were to repair one of the satellites?
Affirmative. A single sensor pulse from one of the satellites would likely be sufficient.
Then that is our first stop.
Shields at 50%.
Hera, I have a visual on the Fury. Is it ready to launch?
Negative. Detecting hazardous levels of radiation. Fury controls are currently locked in accordance with Atlas protocols. Please activate the transport's radiation dampener before departure. Shields at 95%. You cannot operate the Fury transport until its radiation dampener is activated, Echo One. Shields at 95%.
Dampening field activated.
Acknowledged. Long-range sensor satellite located. Plotting course.
All right, let's go find our captain.
Select your destination. Destination, sensor satellite A2. Preparing for thruster ignition. Please hold on.
Hera, status report.
Repairs to satellite must be completed before long-range sensors can be restored.
Understood. Hera, what are these unusual growths covering the satellite?
Unknown. Recommend further investigation.
Agreed. Begin new log entry.
Acknowledged.
Curious. Labor units are designed to maintain limited functionality, even after suffering catastrophic damage. But this unit appears to have ceased all internal functions. It is beyond recovery. Commencing visual assessment. Substance possesses an uneven surface and visible diversity, suggesting it is likely organic in nature. Its sudden emergence in our ecosystem would seem to indicate the substance is somehow related to the arrival of the unknown vessel.
Scan data received. Stand by. Amino organic compound. Intact peptide bond. Minimal cellular activity. Preliminary analysis. Dormant biopolymer. Origin unknown.
Doesn't seem dangerous. It does not appear to have survived the vacuum.
Recommend using your scanner to collect additional data. Recommend completing a threat assessment. Advise you establish physical contact with the substance.
I'll need a power cell. Strange. Hera, did you see that? The substance seemed to come alive when the battery got close to it. I think it may be feeding off the power field. I should probably refrain from touching it while in that state. Battery locked in. The power is waking up the unknown substance.
Advise caution.
Now to switch the power controls to battery backup. The satellite is now fully operational. Hera, please begin a long-range sensor sweep looking for any Fury transports.
Acknowledged.
Now to investigate this unknown substance covering the satellite. This switch designates the satellite's power source. It is currently set to draw power from the batteries.
Accelerated cellular metabolism. Pyrolytic reaction detected.
That sounds unsettling.
Recommend completing a threat assessment. Advise only touching the substance in its dormant state. Recommend completing a threat assessment. Advise only touching the substance in its dormant state. Recommend completing a threat assessment. Advise only touching the substance in its dormant state.
A fibrous texture. It does not appear to damage my exoskeleton. It seems safe enough to touch, at least in its dormant state.
Interaction logged. Investigation complete. Logging all observations of the biomass under the heading Unknown Biological Threat.
Very well.
Echo 1. Long-range scanners have located Captain Rhodes' Fury transport. Signal originates from within the unknown vessel.
Understood. Plot a course.
Acknowledged. Fury transport ready to depart. Select your destination. Destination, Fury Transport FR-103. Preparing for thruster ignition. Please hold on.
Hera, take us along the starboard side of the vessel. Begin scanning the hull for distinguishing features or markings.
Acknowledged. Advised. Reducing speed.
What is it?
Possible visual markings identified on hull.
Hold here. I'd like to get a closer look with the Fury spotlight. I can use the Fury spotlight to get a clearer look at these markings. Hera, could this be some form of writing system?
Cross-referencing against all known written communication systems in the Atlas Interplanetary Database. No matches found.
Assemble a table for lexical analysis. We need to keep moving.
Acknowledged. Re-engaging thrusters on your input. Select your destination. Warning, obstruction ahead. Searching for alternate route.
Dead end. I can use the Fury spotlight to help Hera find a clear path. There, that passage looks clear. Hera, can you confirm?
Affirmative. Plotting new course. Plotted. Signal when ready to proceed. Select your destination. Proximity alert. Brace for collision.
Give me an analysis of this vessel's design, layout, construction, anything that might help to determine its origin.
Affirmative. Stand by. The vessel's overall configuration is unfamiliar to Atlas databanks. However,
certain
elements of the internal design would suggest...
Hera. Hera, do you copy? The ship must be interfering with our comms. Liv's signal is coming from somewhere in the vicinity. I should investigate the area. The vessel is highly irradiated. Liv's transport must have had a radiation dampener. I may be able to reactivate it. That should protect me from the radiation. Liv must have used this to find a way inside. Emergency beacon. I should scan it to see if Liv left a message.
To anyone receiving this message, this is Captain Olivia Rhodes. I'm alive, at least for the time being. Kronos 2's ability to sustain life has been compromised, and I've been left with little choice but to seek refuge aboard this. Unknown vessel. If you're receiving this, Titan Command, please send help as soon as you can. The area is heavily irradiated and... Oh, shit. I can't stay here. Maybe I can get inside. Right, Captain Rhodes signing out.
This could be some sort of control panel, but it has no obvious means of engagement. It may not be receiving power. An airlock, but it appears to be offline. unknown alloy. Very strong metallic bonds. Clearly this vessel is made of highly advanced materials. For all the good it did it. Hull here is compromised. I may be able to cut my way in. This looks like some kind of maintenance conduit. I may be able to restore power to this section of the ship from here. Electrical charge detected. This power cell is operational. This looks like an auxiliary power supply, but the biomass has rendered it inoperable. Power cell installed. Now to replace the rest. Looks like the airlock is powering on. If it's functional, that's my way inside. If Liv came this way, she may still be in range of my personal communicator. Liv, do you copy? Olivia, are you there? Still jammed. No choice but to follow her trail for now. The cabin is pressurized, but the air is reading unbreathable. Could it be the biomass? The data displayed here does not match any code or language listed in my database. This is similar to the emergency junctions on the Kronos. I may be able to redirect the power flow, but I'll need to cut this cover off first. A large compartment, roughly humanoid in shape. This could be a staging area of some sort. Thank you. I'm detecting a charge from this device that's similar to the Kronos 2 induction panels. Perhaps I can use it to recharge. I'm able to draw power from this. I can use it to replenish my radiation shield if necessary. It looks like I can access the ship's infrastructure from here. This airlock is damaged beyond repair. I'll need to find another way in. The door is blocked by the biomass. I'll need to find another way around. Those spores could be what's contaminating the air supply. These spores detonate on contact. They would deplete my radiation shield in short order if I don't avoid them. Widespread biocontamination. I should be careful. Biomass over there went dormant when the power failed. It seems to be tied directly to the vessel's power grid. This bulkhead is sealed. Maybe I can cut through to reach the locking mechanism. Locking mechanism released. Now to pry the door open. Spore detonated on contact with my cover. Maybe I can clear some of the contamination. This appears to be releasing spores into the air supply. A bioweapon, perhaps. I can re-enter the main cabin from here. Curious, these warheads don't match anything in my database. What is that? Strange. This area is highly irradiated. My scanner might help me find a safe path across. Electrical relay armature. The weapon's loading mechanism. The doors here must still have power. Thank you. radiation levels falling, the warheads here must be unarmed.
Captain Olivia Rhodes. I'm leaving this beacon for the record. On the off chance, someone finds this. So far, I've found no sign of life here. Aside from the biological contaminant that's rendered the air unbreathable. That includes both human life and... aliens? Oh, I can't believe I'm even saying that. But the technology on board doesn't match anything used by Atlas or the USN, so I have to consider the possibility. Though whoever's ship this is,